dandruff. There's a 50% chance that you'll suffer from it sometime in your lifetime. But if you already do, then fear not, because there are ways to combat it. So I'm in London this week because I'm doing some work for Reckitt Benckiser. But before we begin this week's video, I received a lot of messages to make a video on dandruff, which is why I'm doing it. But some of them have actually been quite upsetting to read. So I just want to say, if you suffer from dandruff, which a lot of people do, it's not contagious, it's not because you have poor hygiene, and it's a natural process. So if anyone says anything to you, please don't let it get to you. Remain positive and keep on being amazing. Now that's better. So dandruff is surprisingly caused by a fungus, which most of us have living naturally on our skin. And it causes problems for about half of us. The fungus is actually quite difficult to pronounce. It's called Malassezia globosa, which feeds off the natural oils on our skin and hair, and it produces something called oleic acid, which always reminds me of that Nike advert. I don't know if you remember, it had Ronaldinho in it. He used to do some skills and he kept saying, ole! Yeah. If you do remember that advert, leave a comment below and make me feel better. Now, the oleic acid can irritate our skin, causing that itchiness. And in some people, it can actually set off an immune response, causing a rapid turnover of skin cells. Dandruff usually appears as small, brown, white to grey patches on the scalp. It's usually most severe in the winter when it's colder, and mildest in the summer. Background done, now let's move on to treatment. So my first tip, don't add oils to your scalp. It's not really going to help and it's just a waste of your money. Remember what I said earlier about the Malassezia globosa. It feeds on the natural oils on our skin and hair. So washing out these natural oils is far more likely to help. There's also an antifungal shampoo that can help kill those pesky fungus, and it's effective for treating dandruff. It's called ketoconazole shampoo and it can be purchased from any pharmacy. Now my top tip for anyone using this shampoo is don't use it like a normal shampoo. So normal shampoo, you rub it in your hair, smells great, wash it off. But with this, rub it into your scalp and leave it in there for 5 minutes before you wash it off. That will give it the best chance of working. And as always, make sure you read all the information that comes with it so you can learn how to use it and also to make sure that it's suitable to use it. Now you may find that after a while, the effects of the antifungal shampoo begin to wear off, which is why it's important that you alternate it with different shampoos to prevent this from happening. Here's a quick breakdown of the different ingredients found in shampoos and what they do. I think it'll be useful for you to know, as you can then tailor it to your needs. Coal tar shampoos can slow down the skin turnover, but it may discolor fair hair. Salicylic acid shampoos can help get rid of flakes. And shampoos containing zinc or selenium can also target the fungus. So there's a wide range of solutions that you can try. But before you do so, always speak to your amazing pharmacist first so they can give you more advice and tips, and to also make sure that it's suitable to use these shampoos. So to summarize, try these shampoos for about a month to see if there's any improvements. You may need to try a few different types of shampoos to see which one works best for you. But if you still see no improvement, then see a doctor so they can exclude any other potential skin conditions. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Background done, now let's go to treatments. Malassezia globosa. No? Other shampoos to prevent this from happening. Here's a quick Malassezia globosa. It's the globosa.